Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light?
On Tuesday, November 11th, students at Forest Edge Elementary School in Reston observed Veterans Day by hosting veterans from the community. The veterans appeared on the school's news program, where they led the Pledge of Allegiance and spoke about their military service.
The privilege of serving with over 600,000 airmen all across the world and joining our joint services all across the globe. Thank you for honoring our veterans, and we're glad to be here today.
After the news program, the veterans listened to student presentations about veterans.
They're the ones with the courage. They're the ones who win. They're the ones who fight for us. They're the ones who can take the pain, the grief, the risk, and the hardships. For they, them only, are the veterans.
My veteran that I chose is Harry Freeman. He was in the Army and fought in World War I. As a member of the 313th Machine Gun Company, Harry Freeman spent much of the war buried deep in the notoriously brutal trenches of France.
The veteran I chose was Harold Riley. He was part of the Air Force and he was in Unit 24th Aero Squadron. He served in France and Germany.
The person that I searched for is Doyen Parsons Wardwell. He fought in 1914 to 1918. The branch that he was in is Army Air Forces Corps.
When the United States entered World War I, Harold Riley said, and I quote, "I believe that the excitement and thrills of military action could be better appreciated from close contact with real fighting." Despite the fact that his father was diagnosed with diabetes, his family endorsed him to serve.
His diary offers striking descriptions of the World War I combat experience. Consistent artillery fire, very little fresh water or food, and the day that it all ended, November 11th, 1918.
Wardwell flew pursuit bombing and escort missions and made some of the first night flights over the war zone. He documented his exploits over England and France in a diary and a letter home to his new bride.
At the time of the armistice, Freeman's unit was caught in a trap, surrounded on three sides by German troops, and might not have survived much longer.
In October 1918, his plane was shot down and his observer, Sam Keesler, was killed after the crash. After his death, the Keesler Air Force Base in Mississippi was honored after him.
They fight for freedom.
We applaud their bravery.
They are our heroes.
Our country needs their service.
We admire their sacrifice.
The veterans also toured Forest Edge, stopping by classrooms to speak with students about their military service. Captain William Kennedy, retired of the United States Navy, spoke about his service aboard submarines in the North Atlantic during the Cold War. Lieutenant Victor Podell, retired of the United States Army, spoke about his service during the Vietnam War. The veterans answered a wide variety of questions, such as what inspired them to join the armed forces, what foods they ate, the dangers of working near a nuclear reactor aboard a submarine, missile drills, and encounters with aquatic animals.
A lot of animals in the ocean make noise. Shrimp make clicking noise. There's a hammerfish that sounds like carpenters working outside. So you can identify a lot of fish by the kinds of noises they make.
Captain Kennedy and Lieutenant Podell, accompanied by Captain James Cannon, retired of the United States Navy, also spoke with kindergartners.
The armies fight the bad guys.
Yes.
The Army fights the bad guys, but the Navy fights the bad guys too. The Navy fights them on the oceans, and the Army fights them on the ground.
The Veterans Day observance at Forest Edge was a meaningful tribute to the real-life heroes that serve and protect our country.
Thank you for inviting us in.
Yeah, thank you very much.